Throughout history, countless myths and scientific theories have tried to explain the universe's origins. How did the universe come to be? Why is there something rather than nothing? These questions have been asked since humans first developed language, and they're just as important today as they were in ancient times. Many scientists and philosophers have tried their hand at an explanation, but no one so far has had a truly compelling explanation.
I'm happy to say when I don't have an answer to something. I don't know. The proper question would be what started it, because who implies that there's some kind of human entity, but I don't know. If I don't know, I'm going to say I don't know. There are people, though, among us, who when they don't know something, they still have to have an answer. Think of the people who spot UFOs in the sky. There's some light moving in a way they don't understand, so it's an unidentified flying object. But listen to what they do next. They say, wow, I don't know what I'm looking at. It must therefore be intelligent aliens visiting us from outer space. You have not justified that you now know what it is after you just said you don't know what it is. So if I don't know how the universe got here, I'm not going to then assert that I know. I'm going to say, I don't know, we got top people working on it.
In an accessible and engaging exploration of some of today's leading ideas and discoveries, acclaimed physicist Lawrence Krauss shows that nothing is certainly not nothing. According to Krauss, rather than being fundamental and inexplicable, darkness, not light, is the more mysterious phenomenon.
Nothing really describes the revolution in our thinking about some concepts which have been around as long as people have been talking about them, namely nothing and something. The question, why is there something rather than nothing, has been around with, in one form or another, through philosophy and religion for much of human history. And what science has done is change the playing field of those very questions, because what we've discovered, among other things, is that what most people would consider to be nothing is not only not boring, it's actually a very interesting thing, but actually nothing can become something. In fact, nothing can be unstable. Now, what do I mean by that? We've discovered that empty space, which is for most people nothing, you take a region of space and you get rid of all the particles and all the radiation, so there's nothing there. First of all, we've discovered one of the most amazing things is that if you get rid of everything, that empty space actually weighs something. We don't really even understand why, but we have some inklings, because we know, because of quantum mechanics and relativity, at a fundamental level, empty space is a boiling, bubbling brew of virtual particles that are popping in and out of existence in a timescale so short you can't see them. Now, that sounds like philosophy. It sounds like counting angels on the head of a pin, but it's not. Because while we can't see those virtual particles directly, we can see their effects indirectly. In fact, we can calculate their effects, and they affect the properties of atoms in a calculable way. And including those effects has led to the best predictions in all of science. We can compare our theoretical models with observation and get agreement to 9 decimal places. Nowhere else in science can we do that from first principles, predict something to that kind of accuracy, but we only get the right answer if we include the effect of these weird virtual particles. So as crazy as it is, it's true. Now, because of that craziness, it means that empty space can be endowed with properties we wouldn't have imagined before.
The Big Bang Theory is widely accepted as the best explanation we have on how the universe came to be, although not everyone agrees on whether or not it can explain why there is something rather than nothing. The theory emerged in 1929 through a number of independent breakthroughs. The development of modern science depended on these breakthroughs in physics and cosmology, which represented a sea change in our understanding of the natural world. Stephen Hawking was one of the greatest theoretical physicists of the modern age. He explained how the universe began from a point called the singularity. This primordial singularity is itself sometimes called the Big Bang, but the term can also refer to a more generic, early, hot, dense phase of the universe. In either case, the Big Bang, as an event, is also colloquially referred to as the birth of our universe, since it represents the point in history where the universe can be verified to have entered into a regime where the laws of physics as we understand them work. The Big Bang predicts that our local universe came into existence with a brief burst of inflation around 13.7 billion years ago. The model is based on two assumptions. The first is that Albert Einstein's general theory of relativity correctly describes the gravitational interaction of all matter. The second assumption, called the cosmological principle, states that an observer's view of the universe depends, neither on the direction in which he looks nor his location. This principle applies only to the large-scale properties of the universe, but it does imply that the universe has no edge, so that the Big Bang origin occurred not at a particular point in space, but rather throughout space at the same time. These two assumptions make it possible to calculate the history of the cosmos after a certain epoch called the Planck time. Not much is truly known about this period of time, however, some very interesting hypotheses have been made. Einstein's theory of relativity proposes that the gravitational singularity may have existed. In a gravitational singularity, even the laws of quantum physics break down and the four fundamental forces, strong nuclear, weak nuclear, electromagnetic and gravity, could be unified as one. But what came before the Big Bang? Scientists have yet to determine what prevailed before Planck time. Hawking gave a proposal concerning the state of the universe prior to the Planck epoch, but for him, the question of what came before the Big Bang was meaningless because, to all intents and purposes, time itself, as well as the universe and everything in it, began at the Big Bang.
To ask what happened before the beginning of the universe would become a meaningless question, because there is nothing south of the South Pole.
He suggested that if we could travel backwards in time towards the beginning of the universe, we would note that quite near what might otherwise have been the beginning, time gives way to space, such that at first there is only space and no time. According to the Hartle-Hawking proposal, the universe has no origin as we would understand it. The universe was a singularity in both space and time. Pre-Big Bang, however, Hawking did state, the universe has not existed forever, rather the universe and time itself had a beginning in the Big Bang. It simply has no initial boundaries in time or space. A universe from nothing is an accessible and engaging exploration of some of the latest ideas and discoveries being offered as explanations for how the universe came to be. So, how does something come from nothing? This is perhaps one of the greatest questions of all, because it's essentially asking not only where did everything come from, but how did all of it arise in the first place? According to Hawking, because there is a law such as gravity, the universe can and will create itself from nothing. Spontaneous creation is the reason there is something rather than nothing, why the universe exists, why we exist. According to Krauss, all signs suggest a universe that could and plausibly did arise from a deeper nothing, involving the absence of space itself, and which may one day return to nothing by processes that may not only be comprehensible, but also processes that do not require any external control or direction. And it is this possibility which intrigues Krauss and other scientists, who now pursue a deeper understanding of nothing in the hope that it will reveal new insights into how the universe operates.
We still don't get the right answer when we try and calculate the energy of empty space completely in the universe, and it's a big mystery. It's the biggest mystery in all of science. But we know that it can have weird properties. Now, once you add gravity to the mix, and gravity allows things to have negative energy as well as positive energy, then empty space, in which there are no particles, can spontaneously produce particles because you don't violate the conservation of energy. Afterwards, at the beginning you have zero total energy. Afterwards you have zero total energy. But at the beginning you had emptiness. And afterwards you have a universe full of stuff. And it seems like a miracle. But you don't need a miracle to do it. You just need the laws of nature. And in fact, you're guaranteed that if you wait long enough, empty space will produce particles. And so nothing is unstable. So one of the answers to that question, why is there something rather than nothing, is that nothing is unstable. It'd be far more surprising to find nothing than something in some sense, but we wouldn't be here to ask the question if we did. Now, there are many more fascinating aspects of nothing, because it turns out that you might say, and some people do say, that empty space alone isn't nothing. That after all, where did the space come from? And of course, it turns out, as we've been trying to understand the laws of physics and apply quantum mechanics to gravity, that space itself can be a dynamical object. We know in general relativity, space expands and contracts and bends in the presence of matter. And if you make it quantum mechanical, then even space can pop in and out of existence where there was no space before. So you can create whole universes where there was no universe before. And indeed, in that way, you might be imagined creating a universe from literally nothing, no space, no time. And these ideas are amazing and fascinating. And we can't prove that we came from nothing that way, but we can show it's plausible. And the fact that it's plausible, that we can have a set of normal physical mechanisms that take us from no space, no particles, to a universe like the one we live in, which has all the characteristics of a universe we might have expected to be created from nothing, to me is one of those amazing stories one can tell, which is why I just told it.
Thanks for watching. Did you like this video? Then show your support by subscribing and ringing the bell to never miss videos like this.